Naughty baby. Whatever were you about? What if everyone should run away from home? Why, there would be no more home at all. And then what should your mummy do but cry? You don't want your mummy to cry, do you?
Elizabeth, we're leaving. We're leaving now.
Come back, you naughty baby.
Oh, yes, if it were up to you, we'd accomplish nothing.
Sarah, no one doubts your drive for a moment.
Elizabeth! Elizabeth Taylor, are you deliberately being naughty?
I merely question if it's natural to put a child out to work.
Oh, and you're such an expert on the natural order, Francis. Besides, I'm hardly sending her off to the coal mines. I merely want Elizabeth to have a chance to be more than an...
art dealer's wife?
Oh, my, we're full of canny wisdom this morning, aren't we? Get the bloody dogs. Elizabeth, tell Daddy this is what you want. Tell him Mummy isn't forcing you to do anything. Tell him you have always dreamed of being a movie star.
But I haven't.
What? Is this your doing?
Bye-bye, Elizabeth.
Bye, Daddy. I want to be an actress. Actresses can make people believe anything.
Yes, well... actresses go hungry. I know. I saw enough of them when I tried for a career in the theatre. Here you go. Hop in. But movie stars have everything. All right now. You mustn't keep Aunt Hedda waiting.
Is Miss Harper really my aunt, Mummy?
Pet. Hedda Hopper may well turn out to be our fairy godmother.
Danube's so blue, I'm longing for you. My heart's ever true.
Sarah,
that we knew.
Perhaps if she had some accompaniment.
I can't play. Perhaps you...
Oh, God, no. That's just there for show, like everything else in this town. And Sarah, she is a lovely child, but... Elizabeth, the world is full of things for you to do. You can marry, teach, be a nurse. You don't have to be an actress, you know. Not to be happy.
Aren't you in love? Aren't you Mummy's precious love? You're so pretty.
You know, Sarah, I might just have a rabbit or two in my hat.
Okay, Hedda, what'd I do wrong?
Well, don't be such a goose, Sam. Oh, I do hope I'm interrupting.
You are. We're just about to cast the little girl for Lassie. Stick around, you're going to have a scoop for your column.
Oh, really? Well, Sam, you are about to make a huge mistake.
None of them are over 4 feet, Hedda. It can't be that huge.
Well, if you had read my column recently, you would know that very dear family friends have just arrived from London. Moments ahead of the Blitz, as it were.
I'm sorry, Hedda. We've pretty much made our decision.
You think you have. Elizabeth, Sam Marks, permit me to present Miss Elizabeth Taylor.
I've never seen her either.
I know all about this little lady. Her father, Francis, and I were air raid wardens together. He told me his wife was dying to see her in the movies. I told him I'd try and take a look at her. Elizabeth.
Yes, sir?
Elizabeth. Think you can act?
I have, many times.
Yeah, where was that?
Well, a bit at Universal. There's one born every minute. Oh, you must have seen.
I don't think so. Now, Elizabeth, do you think you could talk to a dog and make us believe you believe it?
Could you wait a moment?
Sure.
I know you love me, Lassie. Because no matter how far away you go, you always come back. And you know why? Because you love me. I You don't want your mummy to cry. Do you know a secret, Lassie? If everyone ran away from home, there would be no more home.
Hedda, I owe you.
Of all time, the original Lassie stars in Lassie Come Home. You must see the original Lassie in her greatest movie role, Lassie Come Home. Introducing Elizabeth Taylor.
Darling girl, you've got wonderful reviews for your work in Lassie. I wrote one myself, remember? Why not rest a bit on your laurels?
But Aunt Hedda, it really is my favorite book.
Elizabeth, I think Mr. Mayer knows best. Besides, your plate is quite full with White Cliffs of Dover. Your time will come, dear. It has to, with Lassie such a huge success.
It isn't fair. I was born to play Velvet Brown. I ride like a...
Listen to me, Elizabeth. You could turn yourself into a flying horse, and they still won't give you National Velvet. They're looking for someone more mature.
Taller?
Well, taller, yes. But someone more developed.
You mean...
We'll stick with taller.
Take 2, Parker. Heels down, Elizabeth. Heels down.
What a determined young lady, Miss Taylor.
Elizabeth has really blossomed into Velvet Brown.
What? Are you all right? What is it, your back? Get an ambulance! She's hurt her back!
No, don't do that. I'm fine. Smashing. Imagine I ought to have kept my heels down a bit more.
That was quite a tumble, kiddo.
Who's up?
Oh, let's call it a day, so you...
No, no, don't. I'll be fine. Just let me catch my breath.
You sure?
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
Darling, I know you think I... push too much, too hard. But even I don't expect...
Well, I know that at first I didn't want to be a movie star. But now if I couldn't be in films, I'd feel like a tree that fell down. A tree without roots. Isn't he wondrous? Oh. Loved him at first sight. Do you think he'd give him to me after the film?
Darling... After this film, I imagine they'd give you anything.
A sweeping saga of love, tenderness, and courage. You'll thrill to the new screen sensation, Elizabeth Taylor, as she steals your heart in National Velvet.
Well, so, have you talked to him?
Mm-hmm. He promised me a lining one.
Hi, darling. Janie, why don't you continue with your essay on Wordsworth that you started last week? Dickie, Daryl.
More like last month. I've been writing the same essay through my last two films.
Oh, children, I'm afraid you'll have to forego your science test till tomorrow. Mr. Strickling of Publicity wants to come in and make a few suggestions before you meet with Photoplay.
Night shoot.
Three in a row, then up at the bloody crack of dawn to study my lines.
It's worth it, though. Everyone says National Velvet will make you a star.
I'm already a star.
three, two.
This is Heather Hopper, and this is Hollywood. Elizabeth Taylor is in New York to be photographed for her 17th birthday spread in Life magazine by Philippe Halsman.
It's rather scary. I mean, Life magazine.
It's your birthday spread in Life. Huh. I think it's time the studio realize that their baby girl is all grown up.
At 17?
17? Damn it. You're uncomfortable?
No. Maybe.
No, why? Because I am focusing on your whole body. It is a woman's body. Stunning. Like a woman. Free. Like a woman. Sensuous.
I don't know. Inside, I still feel like a girl.
But you're not a little girl. You are a woman. Yes. 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 You have bosoms, so stick them out.
Mr. Montgomery Cliff.
It's beautiful, isn't he, Mommy?
Go say hello.
Ready?
Morning.
Morning.
Don't do that.
Do what?
Stare at me.
Oh, God. Me too. I'm so tired of people staring at me and telling me I'm beautiful. I hate it.
Well, you are beautiful. And it says so right here. And I'm beautiful. These are the movies. Even the ugly people are beautiful. So what?
I'm Elizabeth Taylor.
Monty Clift, how do you do? Listen, you know what the word is around here? You're the girl on the candy box cover. Is that what you want? To be a thing? Because I have to be honest with you, Bessie May. I don't do my best work opposite a mannequin.
Well, then you better help me, Mr. Method Acting, because I've done my finest work opposite a horse and a dog.
Uh-oh. Oh, dear.
What's wrong? Are you all right?
Some dog biscuits for the shakes. Great method actor, huh? Still getting stage fright.
Pain pills for my back. Came courtesy of National Velvet.
Oh, we're a sorry pair, Bessie May. A sorry pair.
Bessie May. Monty, look at you. You're so thin. Come, let's eat something.
Oh, damn it, I'm not hungry.
Oh, come on. You look as though you never eat and you have to. You can't live on... Go on, then. Do it for me. Do it for Mama. Do it for Mama.
Get inside now. Get the weight up.
Hey, Judah,
you want to go out for dessert?
Oh, good grief. I got the same hand I did last time.
I bet it, John.
Me too.
Come on, Elizabeth.
Rewrite for the next scene.
What you think?
Yeah.
Seriously,
I thought.
But what the hell is this? This is ridiculous. No young lady would speak this way to the man she loves.
She will.
Gotta be bluffed.
Elizabeth, will you pay attention to the game?
Come on.
happiest person in the world.
Second happiest.
Oh, Angela, if only I could tell you how much I love you. If only I could tell all.
Tell Mom.
I was right, wasn't I? About that new line.
Don't be ridiculous. No woman wants to be mama to the man she loves.
Why don't you take the day off from work? Huh? We could drive down to the beach or something.
Yeah. Knock, knock. I come bearing gifts.
Well, hello, Bessie May. What a lifesaver. Give me a minute, Billy. We'll go for our little drive.
Right.
Okay?
I'll see you later.
I'm sorry. I'm interrupting.
No, no, no. No, no, no.
Now you hate me?
Hate you? God, Monty, I love you.
I know.
I have since that first day when you refused to speak to my breasts.
Well, Bessie May, let me now address your breasts.
Stop.
Don't give me so much credit.
Oh, damn you. You've broken my heart.
I know, hell, I've broken my own. You're the girl, Bessie May. If anyone could have wooed me away from my wicked loving.
It doesn't matter. Whatever happens, I will always be here for you. Mama will always be here for you.
Aren't you ever gonna dance?
I suppose.
It's Monty, right?
Oh, that is so silly, just because I want to be alone with my thoughts.
You are still in love with that guy.
Monty and I have great respect for each other. He understands the nature of
love. Excuse me? Ever since A Place in the Sun, you have become queen of the world.
No, Debbie, it's like your souls meet somewhere else and they come here. And if they don't meet again, then you spend your whole life like a wanderer, searching.
Jeepers.
Jeepers. I tell you something as deeply moving as that, and you answer me like a teenager.
I am a teenager, and so are you.
God, no one treat me like a grown-up.
Well, that handsome hunk over there seems to think you're grown up enough.
Who said the owl is that? Mickey Hilton.
Who? His parents only own the Waldorf Astoria and about 100 other hotels.
He's coming this way. Say something.
Broccoli, broccoli!
Stop it, Debbie.
Excuse me. You don't know who I am, but we're Liz Taylor.
Oh, I hate that name.
Liz or Taylor? I can change one of them.
Liz.
I'm Nicky Hilton.
And this is a close friend of mine, Debbie Reynolds.
Debbie? As her close friend, do you think Elizabeth should dance with me?
I am always telling Elizabeth what to do, and she never listens.
Okay, wise guy, what should I do?
Go dance with him.
Thank you.
picture number 17271, Father of the Bride, director Vincent Minnelli, actor Elizabeth Taylor.
Turn, please. Turn right and left.
It's crazy, I know, so sudden. But if I mean to escape, I've got only two options. College or marriage? I mean, with everyone making my decisions for me, I can't even pee without instructions.
Oh, Bessie Mae, sounds like you're going method on me, what with the father of the bride and all.
Be serious.
Okay. You love this guy?
Would you mind?
Just want you to be happy, that's all. You be careful, though. Whatever you decide, I heard a few things.
Oh, you mean he's not an actor or suffering poet? I do believe you're jealous.
Okay, maybe I am.
Oh, good.
Next, Liz.
Well, I want nothing more than to spend the rest of my life as Mrs. Conrad Nicholson Hilton Jr.
Oh, good evening. Hasn't it been a lovely day? Do please follow me. Mr. Taylor. This is your table?
Wrong, pal. We're looking for the table of Mr. and Mrs. Hilton.
Oh, Mr. Hilton, I do apologize. This, of course, is your table.
Thank you.
Well, bon appetit.
Husband. I've only been able to say that for a week. Husband, husband, husband. Promise you'll love me forever. No more than forever.
Fine.
If you're an actor, I'd make you work on that reading.
Well, I'm not an actor, okay? You got that?
Oh, please, this is my honeymoon.
Oh, please, just one.
Yes, please.
Are you famous, too?
Not two old bats like you, I'm not.
How the nerve of him.
Thank you. This is my honeymoon.
Mine too.
Well, don't embarrass me.
Waiter, bring us a fifth of something. Gin. And race.
Gold.
Three threes, pull.
That's what I call
beats
me. That's good.
You?
Mm-hmm.
Are you all right?
Yeah.
Wimbig?
Yeah. Don't ever pull that Hollywood star crap with me again, you bitch.
Oh.
There were many violent outbursts. He was indifferent to me.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Hilton. We just can't hear you.
He was indifferent to me and caused me great mental anguish.
I understand that you have substantial income of your own and you wish to waive any alimony, and that you petition for the right to resume your maiden name.
Yes.
Divorce granted, this marriage is dissolved.
I've let myself in.
Mother, this is my place.
Well, shall I go back out and knock? What's that you're cooking? French toast for lunch? Well, I won't say a word. Isn't this nice? Your own place. My little girl, all grown up. You know, we haven't said a thing about Ivanhoe yet.
I am committed, but terrible script.
Well, that may well be, but a few months in London, away from all the press, help them forget about your marriage.
Mummy.
Darling, clean up that egg, will you? It's dripping.
Mummy, have you spoken with Ben Thaw?
About what?
About London.
Oh, well, I know all about London, darling. We used to live there.
About how I won't be needing a chaperone there.
This was Mr. Thaw's idea.
And even though you'll be staying, you'll still be on salary. Benny promised.
I see.
I'm sorry. But it's as you said. I'm all grown up.
You're burning the toast.
All right, turn over. Camera rolling. Speed. Ivanhoe 72. Marco.
And action.
That is the way it must be, Rebecca. That is the way it must be. Sorry, take it again.
But I don't understand why.
It is the law of the land.
And cut. Is there some problem, Elizabeth?
Yes, this headpiece weighs a ton. It's killing my poor back.
Well, I'm more concerned about dialogue. Can we put a little life into it?
You should have told that to the writer.
Sir Walter Scott, he's dead.
Tell me.
Well, if it isn't Michael Wilding, England's answer to Robert Taylor.
I could never aspire to fill your chainmail, Robert.
Slumming, Michael? Or have you rediscovered a passion for Sir Walter Scott?
Now, as a matter of fact, I've become all curious about the ways and habits of Hollywood starlets.
This one's having a fit.
Quite fantastic. Just like a storm at sea. Don't care how many ships go down, just as long as we can watch them.
Am I allowed to meet your friend?
This is Michael Wilding. Michael, this is Elizabeth Taylor.
Hello. Fine.
My dear, you look enchanting. Please.
Would you believe this is the first night I've been out on the town?
You know I don't. A beauty like you.
Strange. Everyone takes for granted that I have a date every night and nobody thinks to ask.
Oh, so I'm Mr. Nobody.
You are funny.
Well, for an older man.
Stop that. My father's an older man.
Are you quite sure you wanted to say that?
I like older men. They're wise about things like, you know, life, love.
I'm not sure anyone's really that wise. Not about love. The poets claim it, but I don't think they really know what they're complaining about.
God, if you couldn't believe in love.
Do you believe in love?
I used to. It used to be the most important thing in my life.
I'm terribly sorry.
I'll bet you'd marry me if I were older, wouldn't you?
I tell you what, you stay the same age, and I'll get younger.
Elizabeth, please, no thanks are necessary. We've always been a family here at Metro. Besides that, Michael's a great actor. We'd be more than happy to put him under contract.
Oh, it would be such a help to us. Thank you. Also, alone, we would love to get a house, a big house. We're so eager to start a family, you know. We have dozens of children.
Yes, but not too soon. Elizabeth, we have big plans for you, you know.
You are so defiable, you know that?
Look, Michelangelo had the roof of the Sistine. I make do with only slightly less space.
Bugger off, you British weasel.
You're as big as a barn, mad as a hatter, and I love you and I want you.
Don't forget to sign me.
You won't believe this script, the studio sent me. It's nonsense. Utter nonsense.
What is this, the third, fourth script you've rejected? No play, no pay, Michael. Read the fine print.
It's as if it's anything top drawer. I mean, a man does have his dignity.
Dignity doesn't pay the bills. I do. I've done four dreadful films back to back, and to be perfectly honest with you, I feel as though I'm drowning. A bit of help from the home front wouldn't be amiss.
Hey, Dollface. You made it.
Yes.
You meet Jimmy?
Hello, Jimmy. Is he always like that?
No, sometimes he's just rude. Hey, George, look who's here.
Hello, Mama.
Hello, Potato Face.
That's right, Dollface. You show him who's boss. You know why you're here. Because I told old George I wanted Liz Taylor, I wouldn't do this damn thing. What do you think of that?
Well, I think you're pretty terrific, Mr. Hudson. A film like that doesn't come along every day.
Well, neither does a face or figure like yours. You're so beautiful, Liz. A man has to squint.
That's the problem. Until you get rid of that phony MGM veneer, you never will be an actress.
Excuse me, Mr. Stevens.
No, it's just not this.
Is this what a real actress is supposed to look like? Hey, I want it understood. I'm more than a pretty face. Got that?
But God pity the guy that doesn't pay homage to that pretty face.
I got a little vodka, mixed it with her vermouthy.
Well, I've got no vermouthy, partner.
Oh, yeah, partner? What do you have?
Kahlua.
Hey, you mind? You know what you get when you mix vodka with Kahlua? Chocolate martini.
Oh,
diabetes.
Silly folk.
Good evening. Could you direct me to Miss Taylor, please?
I'm sorry, sir, but...
Now, I've just flown into this place from an Air Corps base in El Paso. I'm tired, I'm hungry, and I'd like to see Miss Elizabeth Taylor. I am the husband.
Oh, yes, sir. I believe she's having dinner with Mr. Hudson.
A little in love with my leading man. Because I always will. It's nothing.
I guess everything ain't perfect in paradise.
Come on, little boy. Let's go. It's nap time. We can get up and play later, okay?
Thank you. My God, am I having fun?
You will try to be pleasant, won't you? There's some people here that could help you.
No, I haven't got your talent, Elizabeth. I can't just snap my fingers and have any man do what I want.
Am I really so bad?
Bad, no. Spoiled, maybe.
I didn't mean for it to turn out like this. I do love you.
But when business permits. But why should I complain?
Come on, Bessie. Here's some bubbles.
Rock.
What's the skinny on Raintree?
Strictly hush-hush. South loses, you know.
Good script?
Yes, it plays sort of a Scarlett O'Hara gone mad, but I don't get to kiss Clark Gable. I get that sweet pea.
I thought you were too tired to come.
Too tired to come, Michael. But Bessie May called and called.
And what?
She always wins.
Oh, yes.
I guess you want to talk about, well, you know. She has marital problems.
She does indeed. You know, I think Elizabeth's biggest problem is she can have any man she wants.
And that compelled you to cavort in the pool with a couple of, what were they, Michael? Strippers who told everything to Confidential magazine?
Utter nonsense. These girls dropped by. Nothing really happened. And how was I to know they'd sell the story?
Michael, You live in Hollywood, and you're married to Elizabeth Taylor.
No, she was in Texas with what's-his-name doing God knows what. I mean, what was I supposed to do here? And scoop up after the bloody dogs. You know, she sleeps every night surrounded by her animals. I mean, where does that leave me?
Here's to the dogs of marriage.
Cheers.
The best.
Hey, we wanted to just sleep here.
No, really, I'm fine.
You know, it's okay. I'll get in front of him.
What good will that do?
It'll keep him slow. Guide the way for him.
So long.
Be careful.
I'll call you tomorrow.
Thank you.
141.
Vultures, get out of here!
Okay,
go
come
away!
Come on, stay back, please. Stay back.
You
right there?
There's a lot of ways to pull out.
Make some room here.
Okay, yeah, so it went off here.
Yoo-hoo! Monty. Here he is, Monty. Your replacement if you're not back on the set in a week, right? Now, he's good, baby. Trained in the method, you know.
Oh, no.
Yes. I've missed you, you sweet old disaster. But you look great.
So they tell me.
Well, they're right.
Are you so excited about what's going on?
I ran into Mike Todd again last night.
Oh.
He's really great fun. So different than Michael.
What about Michael?
What about Michael?
Michael Wilding?
Michael, it's Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, how nice to hear you.
Tell me, how's Monty getting along?
Oh, he's fine, fine. Michael, I need you to know that I love you and I will always love you.
That's very comforting.
What I'm trying to say, and I want you to hear it from me before it appears in the papers. Darling, I filed for legal separation.
Well, thanks, but I'd rather have read it in the newspapers.
Yes?
I could have pretended it had to do with two other people.
You tell me if I'm interrupting, I'll get lost.
Not at all, Mike. We were waiting for you.
Yes, we were, though I'm not sure why.
Are you leaving?
Me? No. Why? This is my office. It says so on the door. Benny Thorpe.
I thought you was going someplace.
Benny, I think he's being subtle.
Oh.
Hey, excuse me.
Well, hey, don't run off, Benny. Please, don't run off.
Please, play nice, Mike.
Well, I'm not used to being summoned this way, Mr. Todd. Waiting, what is it, 30 minutes?
You comfortable there?
Hey, get your mitts off of me.
There, is that more comfortable? Now, you're the damnedest, prettiest woman I ever saw. That's for openers. Now, I'm going to lay them all out on the table, and I think you ought to take a look and consider the cards I have showing. I was president of my own company when I was 18. The age I am now, and that ain't too old, I produced 16 shows up in Central Park. Maybe you heard of it? The Hot Mikado? Anyway, the bottom line is I grossed $18 million on Broadway. And that's just the cards I have showing. Now, you didn't ask me what my whole card is. You only see the up cards. Nothing but aces. But the whole card is, Miss Taylor, and I will turn it over for you, the whole card is I'm in love with you. And don't argue against it because I know how I feel.
You what?
I know, it surprised the hell out of me too, but not half as much as this, baby. I not only love you, I'm gonna marry you.
What do you say to that?
Speechless.
Great. You believe in fate?
I believe I'm leaving.
Liz? Hey, now don't get on my bad side now.
Don't call me Liz, Mr. Todd.
All right. Miss Taylor, we're getting married because, like I said, it's fate. And I love you.
Did you understand I'm a married woman?
I understand you're breaking up.
It's none of your damned business.
I'm making it my business.
And I don't like being mauled in an office, thrown around the furniture, and told who I'm going to marry next.
You know what this means?
What means?
Means you and me. You are never going to see me again. Ever.
Great to have you back, Monty. You look terrific. Hell, we all should look so good before a car crash. All right, everyone. We'll block in half an hour.
I have a present for you.
A what? Monty. It's your tooth.
I like a good joke.
What are you doing here?
Well, I was flying east on business, and I heard you were back on your feet, and I thought I'd make a little detour, and, Mike Todd.
Thanks, Mike.
Roses are very ordinary.
Well, then I'm glad I didn't bring them for you. My mother had a fondness for roses. I thought they would add to your general enjoyment of the occasion.
Thanks again, Mike. Excuse me.
You're right. Roses are ordinary. And there ain't nothing ordinary about Liz Taylor. Or Mike Todd, for that matter. This is for you.
Mike. God, it's beautiful.
I could be a horse's butt, Liz. I think we've already established that. But I think also that I am the man for you. I think we both know that, too.
Mike, I don't know what to say.
Well, I do. So you just do the listening, all right? Lizzie, you've been married to a kid and an old man. Time you took a mate. You know, one who gives as good as he gets. Sure, I'll roar. So you roar back. Then we'll laugh our asses off while we spend my money.
I heard you always get what you want.
Is that bad?
No, no. I admire a man who can get anything he wants. So long as he sets his heart to it.
I already told you where my heart is set.
Now it's time to kiss. We're up in the sky together. And Mike, look, they're falling. Mike, promise me you'll never leave me. Promise.
You get the picture. The plane is about to taxi out. I'm looking for her. Where is this fathead I married?
This is extraordinary. You mix mashed potatoes with the corn.
And cream.
So call airport security and I say, you guys seen some overdressed fat ass
around? We're not listening, Mike.
You know, it's real important that you two are here with Debbie and me.
Come on, Eddie. Now I'm trying to tell you the story.
Debbie.
Will you listen, please?
To Elizabeth, to Mike, a man as important to me as my own father.
Thanks, kid. Thank you. So anyway, I'm at Heathrow, and our plane's about to hop over the pond, as they say, and I got no wife. She's in the bar.
Flying makes me nervous.
Sucking up all the Bloody Marys.
I was sitting right underneath the loudspeaker, waiting to be called. They never announced the flight.
Liz, you listen to me. You don't hear nothing you don't want to hear. You're like that damn Alice in Wonderland. You were sitting on the other side of the damn looking glass.
Imagine Mike has read Alice in Wonderland.
Sure, I read it. It's a classic.
And you read the entire book? Or some kindly adult read it to you? He's such a child.
Well, I like children.
Yes, Deb, we know.
Cully, is it a federal crime? All I said was I like children.
Look, well, broad, I'm the man here, all right? I'm your kindly adult. So you just zip up your lip. What's the matter with you?
What is that? Oh! You don't be such a Girl Scout.
Hey.
But you really are square.
Is there dessert?
Mikey loves dessert.
wonderful world if you'll only take the time to go around it.
Formally challenging me to undertake a journey around the world in 80 days.
Michael Todd's Around the World in 80 Days. We make all the stops. Two oceans. Five seas. And 16 countries.
Welcome home. I guess it's safe to say that you've taken the world by storm.
It's all Mike. It was his picture. I just went along.
Well, there is an awful lot of publicity about your public spats. The things that
what?
You...
What? Bite your tongue.
Well, you see, I heard that at the London airport they had to call security to separate you two. Something about a champagne bottle.
That is the most filthy thing I've ever heard in my life. Now, I don't usually get cross.
Well, what about this?
Look, I just wish everybody could be as unhappy as we are. Then there'd be no wars and no problems. The world would be quite nice.
Hey, what happened? You know, we have something to say. I say, hey, Liz. She hollers, hey, Mike.
Uh-huh.
Well, I think it's right this case out of that. Too bad. Uh-huh. We're very...
It doesn't matter.
We're so happy.
I don't care what anybody thinks because we know. And we'll know 10 years from now, 20 years from now, if we're still alive.
Oh, Liz. I'm quoting you now. You once said that you had the mind of a child and the body of a woman.
Well, that's when I was 15, yes.
Well, now that you're married to such a man of the world as Mr. Todd, do you think that you're maturing somewhat?
Well, I hope so. Otherwise, I'd be slightly retarded, wouldn't I?
Hey, so you're not playing with children here. It was a very good comeback. Okay, Broad. I am the man here.
Yes, the man.
You want baby now?
With that head. Meow. Meow.
Oh, now don't start with the cat.
Yeah, you don't want me. Hmm? You want your little cat to purr for you.
You're not going to do that picture.
Hmm. You don't want me on a hot tin roof. Want sugar?
You're doing Don Quixote next, and you're doing it for me. You understand
me? Hey, Bozo, you want a fight?
Yeah, you want one?
I asked you first.
Why, you...
So how do you feel, Miss Taylor?
Beautiful.
What are your plans for the future?
What's the baby's name?
Eliza Todd.
Oh, then it's a girl.
Of course it's a girl. The world's not ready for another Mike Todd.
Get a picture. One second.
Mark.
Action. Lizzie Schwarzkopf, I have to admit it, you're damn good. You are.
Hello.
You and mommy.
Hello.
Now, who's going to believe a story like this? The guys aren't going to fall for a dame like you. How's the old back, Lizzie?
Not so bad. Why?
Oh, I sure do wish we were alone right now. I love you so much, it hurts.
All right, that's not too bad.
Well, it doesn't take a medical genius to say, lady, you are sick. 104 sick.
I'm flying to New York tonight. Medical genius.
Nuts, too.
Delusional. It's the fever.
Oh, Mikey Mike. My fathead sweetie. Flyers are giving you Showman of the Year tomorrow night.
So they'll name me it every year.
1,200 people at the Waldorf Astoria.
Am I wrong, Doc?
I'd say there's going to be one less than 1,200 at the Waldorf tomorrow night.
Hey, you listen to your doc. Hey, you guys. Mommy's real sick now.
Yeah,
she's
okay.
Let's
take the puppies and we'll go rustle up some cookies, huh?
Say bye to Mommy.
I love you. I love you.
So was Uncle Doc. This is a good angle.
What, a picture about a corpse?
I'm going to use it in my next picture.
Kiss me.
I already did.
won't change my mind.
Then kiss me for the hell of it.
Oh, God, you make me so happy.
Oh, Mike.
Don't you worry, sweetie. I can fly above any storm. I married you, didn't I? I'll call you from Tulsa.
What time?
3 a.m. sharp.
Don't forget.
Yes, Mommy. Oh, forgot something. I love you.
Medical, not an emergency or anything.
Elizabeth, what's wrong?
It's after 3.
Tell me.
Mike was supposed to call from Tulsa by 3.
Mike can take care of himself.
I have this feeling.
Now, I can hear you smoking.
I'm not.
Liz, you're sick. Go to sleep.
When Mike calls.
Figured out. Mike and I were married 413 days exactly. No one's ever gonna know how much I love that man.
Me too.
Did, didn't you?
Did I ever tell you about the time you said, most boys dream of growing up to be president of the United States. But not me, he said. I dream of growing up and marrying Elizabeth Taylor.
Big, overdressed, fat-ass broad.
You know, when we were in Europe, Debbie and me, and we ran into you and Mike, I have to be honest, I was so envious.
Of what? Our brawls.
Yeah, you two, you so close.
I feel like half a pair of scissors without him.
I think Mike would want you to get on with your life.
Gonna invite me in?
No, I'll come to you.
Yeah, I didn't get a chance to tell you, but the trouble with people dying is it's stupid.
That's what Mike would have said. Oh, Richard, Mike's barely cold and all they can think about is their damn movie.
This town. I found things to shoot, shooting around you. Hey, kid, I've been worried about you.
Thanks. Been on this lot since I was a child. Went to school here. I've given MGM my entire life. And all they can say is, all they want is to stuff me back into the meat grinder.
Hey, I'm with you on this. We'll manage.
They fired Judy. Judy Garland, for God's sake. Gable, Tracy. Oh, and they let Garbo sneak away without so much as a thank you.
Look, I don't give a damn about this picture. We'll recast. You please go home. It's a movie, for crying out loud.
You're one of the few men in this town who'd say that.
Yeah, I'm a hell of a guy.
Mike would want me to get back to work.
Well, if that's what you think Mike would have wanted.
I came here today so you would convince me to come back.
No, you came here to convince yourself. Now, get your butt over to wardrobe.
Hey, I got your message. What's wrong?
Oh, no, nothing. I wanted to give you something. Mike's.
There's a gold money clip?
Are you sure?
Positive. Mike loved you like a son. Me too.
I'd love it if you could come to Vegas to my opening at the Tropicana. Well, maybe that wouldn't be such a good idea. People might think.
Not if Debbie's with you.
She hates Vegas. She can't stand the guys I hang out with. She thinks I gamble too much.
Well, you do.
Yeah. Is that a crime?
Not in Vegas. That's the charm. What do you want? And what do you really want?
I want out.
And what does Debbie want?
She wants the marriage to work.
That is a problem.
I've got a bigger problem. I think I'm falling in love with you. I want to marry you.
Oh, Papa. Oh. Get her up. Mm-hmm. Hello?
Yeah. Deb. Debbie. How did you know I would... Oh. Well, that was a good guess. Debbie, listen. This isn't easy. Elizabeth and I are together here. We're in love, Debbie. She said we'd discuss it. Just come home.
Are you going home, Eddie?
God, how could I?
Frankly, I'm shocked such lies would be printed. Eddie and Liz are just good friends. Now, what's wrong with a good friend taking another friend out for the evening?
Debbie... You do that very well, but this is Hedda. Level with me. We both know Eddie is not exactly Mr. Picket Fence. What's really happening?
All I'm saying is Eddie's a great guy. I love him. Don't blame Eddie.
Level with me. I'll find out anyway. The word is that they are breaking up and you are the cause.
That's bull. I don't break up marriages. Besides, you can't break up a happy marriage.
You cannot hurt Debbie this way without hurting yourself more. Elizabeth, she truly loves Eddie.
He doesn't love her. He never did. The marriage was a farce.
What do you think Mike would think about all this?
Mike's dead. I'm alive. What do you expect me to do? Sleep alone?
You viper!
You depicted me as something cruel and absolutely heartless.
Darling, I only wrote what you told me.
I didn't think you'd print it, for God's sake.
Darling, that's my job.
You betrayed me, Aunt Hedda.
I will never forgive you.
I would imagine Debbie singing the same song these days. Eddie's ruined, of course. Hate mail is flowing in like a flood in the streets of this town. The network's dropped him. Only that element out in Las Vegas will hire him anymore. But the man does have a full-time job. Full-time Elizabeth. But then you'd know all about that, wouldn't you, Sarah?
I won't say a bad word about Elizabeth. But if she had listened to me, this never would have happened. That fisherman has taken her off to Europe for a honeymoon. Elizabeth says she hopes it lasts 40 years.
Poor Eddie.
Hi there. Bonjour. That black monsieur.
That's a police. That's a thought, police.
Monsieur.
Do you speak English?
Monsieur, vous dites.
No, that's okay. It's okay. Just put it down. Put it down. Very good. Very good. That's fine. Oui. This can go downstairs in storage.
Oui,
merci.
Thank you. Oui. Merci, monsieur.
Oui.
Hello.
Did you order me up a scotch?
Give me a sec, babe.
Really, I'm in so much pain. My back again. Are you going to answer that?
Oh, it's fine. Just medicine. Don't worry, it's all been prescribed for me by Dr. Jacobson in New York.
Oh, Eddie, don't you read the magazines? That's Dr. Feelgood. He's notorious.
It's just vitamins and a bunch of other stuff.
Stuff? Damn right, stuff. Stuff mixed with amphetamines. With all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, uppers. So what?
God, this frightens me. Eddie, how long have you been doing this?
For a while. It helps me perform. What about all the pills you take?
Mine are prescribed by a real doctor, Eddie. Come on.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Hi, Walter. No, I can hear you. It sounds like you're next door. Oh, you're next door to Daryl Zanuck. You're in Hollywood. Very funny. It's Walter Wanger.
Oh, that Cleopatra thing. You talk to him.
He says Fox is ready to go the distance with you.
Tell him I'm too young to go the distance.
Walter? She's in her room now. She's learning French verbs or something, but... go ahead and I'll write it down.
Tell him I'll do it for $1 million against 10% of the gross from the first dollar.
No one's gotten $1 million.
Or a percentage of the gross.
Well, she just stepped in. You sure you want to hear? She says she'll do it for $1 million against 10% of the gross.
From the first dollar?
From the first dollar. All right, Walter.
So what'd he say? Forget it?
No.
Then what'd he say?
He said, I'll get back to you.
No. You can't.
Liz, before we can let you go to England, play Cleopatra for $1 million? 10% of the gross? I have to remind you that you owe us a picture, and that picture's got to be Butterfield 8.
That is outrageous.
I'm afraid it means that you're going to have to do Butterfield 8 for considerably less compensation.
You're asking me to play a whore.
That word does not appear in our screenplay, and I want to remind you that Butterfield 8 is a best-selling novel by a renowned and respected American author.
I don't care. I won't do it. Under any circumstance.
Well, if you refuse to abide by the terms of our contract, I'm afraid it leaves us no choice but to block you from working anywhere for the next 2 years.
And this is how you choose to end an 18-year relationship.
Liz, sentiment went out of this business years ago. Adjust. I've had to. Oh, yes, but that's the business. Personally, me, I'm still a very sentimental guy. I remember the luck we made with National Velvet and that horse, that beautiful horse, King Charles, that you love so much.
Thanks a lot, USOB. I'm still paying for the feed on that damn nag.
Liz! Lizbeth! Don't do this to me.
You can make me do it, but you can't make me act in it. I'll be unprepared. I'll be late.
I think you're too much the professional for that.
In a pig's eye. But I want Eddie there.
Well, of course.
To play the role of Steve.
What? He's a singer.
Singing is acting. I mean, he's acted in front of hundreds, thousands of people. He's perfect for the role. Do this for me, please. Now, you really are mad at me this morning.
Put your coat on.
Why this morning?
Because I'm sick of opening that door every other day and finding you boozed out, burned up, and... Burned out, boozed up, and... Sorry, baby.
Eddie, you're not even trying. We broke early so that you could rehearse.
I am trying. I never said I was an actor.
No, I did. And what this hateful film doesn't destroy, you will. I staked my reputation on you.
Did I ask for this? Did I ever ask to be in this?
No, you don't ask. You just sit around waiting for Mama to make it better.
Hey. Come on, you two. You don't want to do this.
I do. I want to kill something.
No, Bessie May. Come on, go get dressed. We have reservations at 8. Come on. Eddie, come here. It's all right. Come here. Now, look, you can't just say the words.
You're telling me.
No. I mean, you got to feel past the words. They're nothing, and an envelope, maybe. The message comes from here. The gut.
Sure.
Okay, over here. Come on. This guy's Steve. He looks at this woman. He's had her, right? And he looks at her, and he sees filth. Dirt. You have to look at Elizabeth and see filth.
But I love her.
No. Now, come on, pal. You can do it. Come on. Come on, from the gut. You can do it.
Sick of opening that door every, sick of... Let me walk. I'm better walking. Sick of opening the door every other day and finding you boozed out, burned up, and ugly. Boozed out, burned up, and ugly. Sick of... is on my back about the delays on Cleopatra. They're way over budget. Baby?
What? I'm sick, okay?
I don't know how much of this I can take.
What about me?
Everything is stalled here. I have no career. You're too sick to work. Even if you could, the rain won't stop. This town is like living in the bottom of a damn well.
I hate it too, Eddie.
Maybe I should go back and try and get some work, something.
No, don't start that again.
I said I'm just thinking about it.
I'll tell you what I think about. Every man I've ever known is either... died or abandoned me.
Letters and telegrams and... Look here, here's your obituary. Everyone loves you.
Everyone loves me dead. Alive. I'm the whore of Babylon.
No, babe, no. They love you, the fans. They forgive you everything.
I'll let them know when I am.
Now, is that a new way to get better?
Me? I missed you so.
Baby.
Daddy. Mommy, I saw Mike, I did.
Where, baby?
When I died, I saw him. I wanted so badly to be with him. No, you can't. It's not your time. Go back. Back.
Didi, darling.
Fight. Go back. That's what he said. I'll be here. He said that.
Can you hear that, hon? Would you get a load of that?
Burt Lancaster wins his Oscar against an outstanding field of movie favorites. The distinguished audience is hushed. The tension is great when to Yul Brynner falls the assignment of telling who is best actress.
Elizabeth Taylor.
Escorted by her husband, Eddie Fisher, the star who was honored for her portrayal in MGM's Butterfield 8 comes up to receive the Oscar. A pleasure indeed, for Elizabeth Taylor has won a victory over a near-fatal illness. And this, too, is her fourth consecutive try at winning an Oscar. And now it is hers at last. She is overcome with emotion as the presentation is made.
I don't really know how to express my gratitude for this after everything. Guess all I can do is say thank you. Thank you with all my heart.
Academy Award. Reminder that every moviegoer is also a star maker.
Field 8, Michael Pistacat.
Congratulations. I'm so happy for you. Now, would you like some more good news?
Yes.
We're going to start up again with Cleopatra. Only this time we're going to Rome. We're going to pretend that Rome is Rome.
Oh.
And here's the kicker. Joe Mankiewicz said yes, he'll direct.
Oh, Walter, that's wonderful.
But he wants to recast the men. Only English actors. The cream.
Rex Harrison, of course.
For Caesar, yes. Mm. A real actor. Mm. Man of the theater.
And Anthony, who will play Anthony?
You're going to love this. The best. The new Olivier.
Who?
Richard Burton.
Who?
Ma, 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 ma. Batica, 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 batica.
No, the other one.
I said, get her butt out here.
Just like that, Mr. Mankiewicz?
Yes. But tell her I said it with enormous charm.
That strumpet will be late for bloody judgment day.
I hope you can curb your tongue around Elizabeth.
My tongue's as tame as a gelding.
We have a long summer ahead.
Well, who was it who said that she's all breasts, no legs, and the voice of a fishwife?
Well.
Fishwife and queen.
Your Majesty. Has anyone ever told you what a pretty girl you are?
I know, you're the very first. Let us stick to the dialogue.
The thing that motivates these two, they both needed Caesar, but he's dead. So to keep the power, she hooks into the new guy. But the hook gets her too. For the first time in her life, Cleopatra falls deeply and passionately in love.
But she loved Caesar, yes?
No, not like this. This is mutual. Cat and mouse, where the cat gets the mouse and the mouse gets the cat. And both go under. No survivors.
Oh, that's a chilling thought.
Yes. We must beware, my lady. You can't act falling in love without actually falling in love. It's just a little.
Not me. Maybe a few schoolgirl crushes, but you'll notice I never marry my leading man.
I didn't say marriage, I said love.
Well, I'm an old-fashioned girl, Mr. Burton, just like Mummy raised me. First I love, then I marry.
She says she's an old-fashioned girl, Walter. Whatever that means. Okay, let's see what this looks like.
Quiet, everyone. This is a run-through. Silencio.
And action.
Terribly sorry.
Oh, don't be sorry. Joe, give us a moment. Are you all right?
Oh, it was the late night or the early morning. Can't figure out which one of them got to me.
What you've done.
Cleopatra, I see how you conquer.
You're not still drunk, are you?
No. Still Welsh, though. Same thing, love. Thank you. I promise you better results tomorrow, my Empress.
Well, why don't we call it a day? You go home to your wife and get a good night's sleep.
Yes. Yes, good idea. And you bed down with your merry little fellow, too.
Don't be rude.
You started it.
No, you did.
You did.
Why don't you just try and turn up sober tomorrow?
But I'll turn up sober if you turn up on time.
Isaac, give me a big hug. Sweetie, I love you. What you been doing today?
How was shooting?
Shooting?
Wasn't this the first day with Burton?
Oh, yes. Yes, it was.
So was he sober?
Reasonably. Eddie, are we happy?
What kind of question is that? I think we are. Nobody is happy all the time.
Truly? I don't see why not.
What's got you so stirred up?
I don't know. Something. Maybe only something a woman would get stirred up about. Eddie, I want another child.
Why? You've got it. Wilding's boys you've got. Mike's daughter.
Oh, they're all grown up. I want a baby.
Well, that's too dangerous. You've had three cesareans.
Oh, I know, I know. Three cesareans are out. But I know a baby would make me happy. A baby would need me, Eddie.
All is in order. Here you are.
I named her Maria, after my friend Maria Schell.
She found her for us.
German orphanage.
Hmm.
And this child was examined, declared healthy.
Yes.
Miss Taylor, she has a malformed hip.
Well, so what? She's an angel.
What's involved, Doc?
For her to ever walk, a very long process. At best, she'll have a cast on the left side for at least 6 months.
Well, it doesn't matter. What else is our money good for? I told you she'd need me.
And action.
You intrigue me, my lady.
Allora, signor Rossi,
te l'ho detto.
You
flattered,
except you always fall in love with your leading ladies.
Oh, the gentleman never tells tales.
Gentlemen, my foot.
Thanks.
So you did sleep with all of them?
Oh, long story. What are you doing tonight?
Oh, stop that. We're both happily married.
Are we?
I can speak for myself.
Can you?
I can.
Yes, and of course. But you have the responsibility of the entire company.
I'd say.
It was so good, we're going to do it again.
Oh, we're going to do it again.
All right, everyone, we're going to go again.
Of course,
right
I never
away.
Did find you my type.
For me, you've always been extraordinarily full of yourself.
Oh.
Excuse me for saying so.
Oh, not at all.
I don't mean to be rude.
Perish the thought.
Here, I've got it.
Am I intruding?
Bloody old man.
You old sow, you. Have a drink.
I don't think they were acting. You know, Joe, if anything starts up between these two, it could ruin us. I don't know. He's punctual. At least he might get her to the set on time.
Yeah. My him. He always looks like he needs a good scrub.
He's nasty to her. The only thing she can't stand is the nice guy.
I am like a patient etherized upon a table. But I will be after this. A little more, I think.
True.
I'm not getting drunk.
Well, don't you look handsome?
Oh.
Please, eat.
Oh, thank you. But I think I need a little more of this barking water first.
One thing the Italians know is food. You'd think they were Jewish.
Really? Well, of course, they do say that the Welsh are, in fact, the lost tribe of Israel. Did you know that?
Is that so?
Yes.
I didn't know that.
Elizabeth, this is Sybil, my wife.
Hello. Glad you could come. How do you do? Oh, Eddie, the music's too loud. Go. Hello, Luciana. Well, there are two of them there, Richard. Both your type.
Possible, please.
You better hurry. They might leave.
My pet, you wound me.
Why? Because I'm not blind. Well, of course. Only when it comes to you.
Is this the face that launched 1,000 ships and burnt the topless towers of Ilium? Sweet Helen, make me immortal with a kiss. Her lips suck forth my soul. See, eyes.
What is it, Richard? Tell me.
A play about a rather crazed and wonderful chap named Faustus.
Crazed and wonderful.
Oh, yes. Brilliant fellow. But poor sod.
sold his soul to the devil.
Why?
Why? For the love of the most beautiful woman in the world, of course.
Doesn't sound so brilliant to me. Eddie, will you please? We can't hear ourselves think. I'm sorry, you were reciting.
Oh, thou art fairer than the evening's air, clad in the beauty of a thousand stars.
So this is your charming hideaway?
Oh, I sincerely hope so. Not one single paparazzi in sight.
How do I look?
Ridiculous.
At least no one will spot me.
Spot you? You look like you're wearing a bloody marshmallow on your head. Ow! At last, we seem to have thrown off the shameless shackles of fame and shuffled off that mortal coil.
It's amazing. They were looking for Elizabeth Taylor in Rome, and we left her there.
I suppose it would be a bit of a cliché to jump into bed.
Yes, I think so.
Would it?
Yes.
Oh, what a pity.
I've come too far for that.
And how far have you come?
Too far. You know, Richard, silly as it sounds, I can't remember a time when I wasn't famous. That hasn't left much time for anything else.
Such as?
Well, love. I mean, when I was a child, I never felt like I could get enough love. And all my life, all I wanted was love, more love.
Well, I can understand more lovers.
No, not lovers, more love. The kind of love that you surrender to and that surrenders to you. What do you think?
Oh, I'm just a confusion of liquids. But really, I was, I suppose like all good Welsh boys, I was in love with my mother, whom I never knew, and with my sister, and ever since all my life, I've searched for someone to compare.
Sybil?
That's out of bounds. She makes no demands.
And I demand.
Yes.
You want me? Flaws and all?
Oh, flaws. Flaws, yes, I do want you. You're a deep, vast, terrifying ocean, and I do think that I could quite happily drown in you.
I got a call from the coast today. Apparently there are a lot of rumors going around about you and Burton all the way from the coast. Who'd have thought? Are they true? Elizabeth, are they?
Yes. Excuse us, please.
Are they ready for me?
Terrible reading, ducky. Not even you believe it. Yes, there's a lot of pros sitting out there, sitting on their duffers waiting for you.
Where does the time go?
Oh, I wonder. You were rather a bit of a mess this morning when you came in, weren't you, old girl?
You look like something the cat dragged in, old boy.
Yes, I was hungover. A little too much of the vine last night.
Me too. Pure love. 100 proof.
Ocean, you deceive yourself. That was never love.
No.
No. That was lust.
Love, you bloated old goat.
You
love.
You silly trollop.
I see you need some coaching on the finer points.
It's my blunt point that you admire.
You bloody coward.
You.
Coward.
You scurrilous slag.
Joe. Don't.
You
were going to remind me that I've been sitting here for 40 minutes and I don't want to be reminded.
Oh, good. What in hell were they up to?
They were rehearsing the love scenes. Everything but the lines.
All right, places, everybody.
Elizabeth, you look radiant, my darling.
What a swirl.
The sunshine of our day.
Come, let me show you.
Sure.
Atmosphere, you ready? Camera ready?
Come in. Thank you. Where's Eddie? Eddie? We're about to sit down. What's going on?
Socks. Underwear.
Eddie, stop this.
Look, I'm not going away for good to Don't Go Nuts, okay?
Of course you're not. There's too much going on. Eddie, I'm in the middle of a picture. I need you.
I'm taking off for a few days. I'm going up to Switzerland. I'm going to go look at a chalet. Do you remember a chalet? Our dream.
Eddie, you can't do this.
Why not? You've got people here. You've got Richard.
He has his own wife.
Somebody told me I should buy a gun and shoot the guy.
Oh, stop
it. You think there's a judge in this world that will convict me? Especially in Italy. Here, you know what they would do? Hell, they would stand up and applaud. They would have a parade.
Eddie, listen. Please stay here. I need you. Please stay.
Good evening, sir. Did you know that the verb to be is the most brilliant verb in the English language? I am. You are. We are. Yeah. They are.
It's Richard.
I see.
Amazing. We were just about to sit down.
What's he doing here? What are you doing here?
I am in love with this girl.
You have your own girl. You have Sybil.
Sybil and Elizabeth are both my girls. You are my girl, aren't you?
Yes.
If you're my girl, come here and kiss me.
Yes, she is. Yes, I am. Yes, well, I do know one thing. Will you let me speak?
Thank you. I know that it will soon be dawn, and in that harsh light, my thoughts will clear, and I will rescue my Guinevere. I will do the right thing.
You're not going.
I have to.
You don't have to. You want to?
She's my wife. I have to. What do you want to do?
I want to love you. You said you wanted to get more out of life, and that's what we've got. We are more.
What we get in life, Elizabeth, is that we get to love a little, just a little, and then we get to die a lot.
I don't want to die.
I'll tell them when I get there.
Richard.
Oh, I thought I could get away with it.
With what?
With you. I'm drowning in you. You're an ocean.
You're not actually leaving, are you?
Yes, I am.
Damn you, Richard. How dare you run away from me? I've given up everything for you. I've made a spectacle out of myself for you.
For me?
Yes.
Love, you have thrived for years on the Elizabeth Taylor merry-go-round, and I expect that you always shall. At least until your looks go.
Richard! What do you think? Where's Eddie?
Eddie's gone, dear. Sometime now.
Ah, yes. I'd forgotten. I'd forget my head if it wasn't. I've been a bad girl, Mac. Did you see this? It's from the Vatican newspaper. I didn't even know the Pope had a newspaper. No one's going to tell me who I can and cannot love.
Ignore it.
And they say I'm some sort of erotic vagrant. I mean, whatever the hell that is.
It ain't flattering.
Well, it's a lie is what it is. I mean, I love my children. I'm a wonderful mother. I am. You can ask anyone. God, Meg, what if they try to take little Maria away from me? I've got to wire my lawyers. I can't let that happen.
Nobody's going to take your kid. You just concentrate on getting your feet back under you.
Can you sue the Pope?
Get yourself up. We'll get on down to Ischia, put you on a barge, and finish this picture.
Well, I don't know when I'm going to be able to.
I do. Real soon.
Where's the old Welshman?
Putting his wife on a plane.
Oh?
Yeah, Sybil decided to take the kids back to London. Can't say I blame her, can you?
Ischia.
Hey, no. Ischia. What are you doing?
Ischia, what is that? That's an island, isn't it? God, what a break that will be. The sea, the salt air.
And the moonlight.
Ah! Does Ischia have a great moon?
Afraid so.
Yeah.
paparazzi have discovered Ischia.
Oh, my God. How did this just go away?
Would love how else you might become
a Hollywood star.
Patience, patience, you vultures. Take one last tear at our tender flesh. Soon we will end this endless venture.
Excuse me, Kelly.
Shwe, I can't hear.
Is that some new jewel?
Oh, yes. This is a little emerald brooch which you bought me at Bulgari.
Yes, I introduced her to beer. She introduced me to Bulgari.
Are you two going to marry?
Marry the girl? Never.
Then what's the deal?
Well, not sure I should share this with you. It's such a private thought, but sometimes the heart speaks and you have to. I've always believed that I was a child of destiny. And if that's true, then Richard Burton is surely my fate.
This way, love.
Are you going to...
Darling, what is it?
That's enough destiny for one day.
Oh, are you in one of your black Welsh moods?
I received this.
From who?
Whom?
Whom?
Sir Laurence Olivier. Sir Larry asks me a question. Do I want to be a household name or do I want to be a great actor?
Well, what do you want?
Both.
They've all folded their tents. Romans and Egyptians, and they've all gone home!
Battle's over.
Battle? Is that what it's been?
From day one, yes.
So where do we go now?
Someplace terrifying, like reality.
Oh, do we have to?
No, we could always stay intoxicated for lovely always.
I've always hated the end of filming. People rush together and make some intense, crazy family, and then everybody goes their own way, and it's like 20 forms of abandonment all at once.
Everything ends, Elizabeth.
Everything?
The truth is, you always knew I could never leave her.
I understand. She's a good woman. That's what everyone tells me constantly. She stood by you all these years. Through all your bad behavior?
Yes, I know the story.
So should we go home?
Yes.
Our separate homes?
Yes.
I could make you stay.
Yes.
Then I won't.
Mr. Burton, please, would you hold? Would you hold it, please? Right there.
Thank you, sir.
What's that for?
Oh, it's a phone, Mr. Taylor, in case she needs.
Yeah. Take it away, Mr. Taylor will be fine.
Burton, this way, please.
Yes. Thank you.
Sir,
just turn around slowly, Mr. Burton. Just right there.
Oh,
there. Thank
just
you.
Just give me one more.
That's
Mr. Burton. One more.
Would you mind looking this way, sir? Please.
Excuse me, Mr. Burton. Go ahead.
Thank you.
Yes. Lovely.
No, Grandma, let's go play. Oh, wait, let us be alone for a bit and then we'll come see you, okay?
Yes, darling. Run along. I'll be up later, all right? Elizabeth, this is a dream, an absolute dream.
Well, it's perfect for the children. You have everything you could possibly need here.
Well, except a man. Oh, Mummy, have you heard? Since we stopped shooting, Fox has fired everyone. And Walter Wanger. Oh, and poor Joe Mankiewicz. Now, he should have gotten a medal for having to deal with me.
Elizabeth, you must really try and put Richard behind you.
Well, I've put the English Channel between us. That's a start, isn't it?
It's so strange, you know. You and Eddie bought this house, and then the scandal. Le scandal. Oh, honestly, you'd think the press would have more to write about. So, you really haven't seen him since?
The parting was amicable and mutual. Oh. Bonjour, Chalet Ariel. Oh. Hello. How are you?
No.
Hello,
Miss Taylor.
Please call me Elizabeth.
This way. May I take your coat?
No, I'm fine.
That might be nice.
I've eaten too much.
You've been well?
Very busy.
Good.
You?
Oh, flat, stale, unprofitable.
I keep busy working on the chalet mostly. It's so beautiful. The children love it.
Work. That's what you need. Real work, not this doily arranging. Have you read the script?
Is that why you wanted to see me? Talk about the VIPs?
I've always wanted to see you. Life is worthless without you, but you have seen the script. I know it's lightweight, but the deal...
And you really think that's a good idea? Us working together?
Why not? It's $500,000 each. London. You like London.
And where will you be?
Well, London, of course.
I mean, Sybil's in London. Your family?
Yes. Ah, thank you, Al, for that.
Oh, you're welcome.
Richard, I don't ever want you to hate me.
Oh, I couldn't
respect
possibly.
For me and think
What's
I'm...
got into you, lovey?
You used to call me Ocean.
Well, I still do. My ocean. To me, you're boundless.
I've had a great deal of time to think. And Richard, I need you. All the time, I need you. I know you don't want to marry me or you can't marry me. I've accepted that. It's like swallowing a rock, but it's okay. I'm willing to be your secret.
My secret?
I'll be your mistress. The world will eat me alive if they find out, but at least I won't be hurting anyone anymore.
Oh, my Elizabeth.
Richard, you must promise me something. You must promise never to think bad of me.
Never. Never. Not one single bad thought in this old, drunken Welsh head. Not for Elizabeth.
Promise?
Yes.
Hey,
I ever tell you? About Sir Larry, as we know him.
Stanley Baker!
I was just having myself a tall anesthetic.
Champagne, sir.
Poison all around.
I missed you at the film, Rich.
Yes, I know, I know. Don't tell me. It was rubbish.
And where's Cleopatra?
Cleopatra's in the loo, losing what little faith she had left and losing her lunch.
The thing you sold out, Rich.
Yes, I am old Faustus. Oh, the latter-day Faust. Got a three-picture deal with the devil himself. Or Elizabeth herself. Depends on which rag you read.
She's, something.
Mm. Oh, I spent 2 years making that lousy film and they cut it to pieces. It's appalling.
Seldom in a mountain of film have given birth to such a mouse of a performance.
Killing me by inches.
Oh, love, this one's better. It says here, you're not the worst actress in the world.
How can you read that?
Well, the cure is in the poison.
Oh, what the hell is that supposed to mean?
That means, darling, that it's time I returned to the theater.
Reading that garbage.
Oh.
Apologize.
No.
Apologize.
Make me.
Apologize.
You little spitfire. I apologize. Have another drink. £150,000. How much is that in dollars? $500,000.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
They are simply the most beautiful stones I've ever seen. Are you really?
Well, it's either that or I buy you half of Wales.
You know, there's only one thing that can make me happier.
Shh.
Don't be a boozy old Welshman.
I said shut up. I have something to ask you.
Yes?
Will you marry me?
Have you told Sybil?
Tomorrow.
Are you coming home, sir? I love you. I've missed you so much.
You'll make up for it soon. Go and play with the children. Don't be sad.
No fighting now, okay?
Over here. It's me. Over here.
Are you coming home, Rich?
Dada! Oh! And he's got the ball and Burton's dribbling it around and he's going to throw it to Jenkins Jr. Score, love! What?
Are you coming home?
Home. Yes. Yes.
For good?
Yes.
Have you told her?
I'll tell her tonight.
After 4, I was concerned. How did she take it? Sybil, what did she say?
Not much.
You told her?
No. Oh. No reproaches, no rampage, no threats of death and destruction. Richard, you fool, Richard, you lout, you worm, you insipid. Where the hell do you think you're going?
I'm going to my room, and you're going home to Sybil.
The hell I am. I'm coming through that door.
You'd better bring a locksmith.
You can't toss me out like some errant schoolboy.
Richard, you can have a wife and a mistress. You cannot have a wife and a fiancé.
Why not?
Because I'm the fiancé.
You think just because I'm drunk, I'm not going to remember any of this in the morning, you cow! Ah! You sow!
Sybil, hello, love. Yes, yes, I know it's rather late. Well, it's early, actually. No, I didn't tell her. Well, the thing is, love, I do believe I'm going to need a divorce. Yes, every night the same thing. All of these
vultures.
No, fans, not fans. All come see me. Me.
Love, they come to see us. We're a pair of circus freaks. Though it's true, the only reason they're here is to see sinners on display. It's where he belongs.
You wouldn't mind if he stayed?
Mm. I just want to be with Richard.
That?
Congratulations.
You're such a kind audience, all of you. However, my heart feels other appreciations. I have, at last, married the girl. And indeed, she is such a treasure that I must honor her.
Don't turn your back. They love the lions as much as they love the Christians.
Ladies and gentlemen, as the bard would have it, we will have no more marriages.
So you've both undergone a lot of changes to play in Virginia Woolf.
Now you be sure and tell your readers this is part me, part foam. I gained 15 pounds in 15 years, and for the first time, the studio insisted on it.
You ever feel like you've become this woman?
Only on the set. Richard doesn't let me use four-letter words at home.
Yes, I've cured Elizabeth of that rather unfortunate tendency.
You bet your ass.
That's a three-letter word. Of course, my only concern is that my quality is not exactly this American professor gone to see. He's not...
Rich?
He's not me, this moon-faced chap beaten down by a woman.
Richard!
Thank you, Mr. Burton.
Wish just leave the phone. Yeah.
You're mumbling.
I'm running my lines.
Mumbler.
One of your less glaring defects, Elizabeth, is you've never been able to distinguish between art and mumble.
Can't you? You're a mumbler. Is that your lines?
Page 4. It says George takes the bottle. And pour.
Don't you think you've rehearsed that one enough?
Oh, it's method, darling. You see, I'm sensing my way into the role of a drunk.
For years.
You see, that hurts. I have a reason to drink.
Page 27. Martha takes a chicken leg from the refrigerator. It's in the script.
I never have for the life of me understood your attraction to those poor birds.
Really? Well, listen, Buster, maybe that's one of your defects and a big, fat, glaring
Why
one,
don't
too.
You swallow first?
All your nutrients come in bottles. You know, you ought to try food sometime.
It's all of God's poor little birds that I'm concerned for. They seem naked and vulnerable.
Oh, brother.
Have you ever considered that you should, eat only what you can kill?
I've considered snapping your fat little Welsh neck.
Give me vegetables myself. For instance, the hops or the juniper one finds in gin. The
blah, 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 blah.
The Russians turn to the magic of vodka. I'm a vegetarian.
I'm speechless.
Oh, I hope not. I'd miss your voice, my little dove.
You'd be thrilled.
Not so. Like the sailor, I take comfort there, off in the mists, the distant hooting of your little horn.
Bullseye!
I'm prepared to sacrifice many things for our relationship, Elizabeth, but my dignity...
Oh, dignity?
No.
Dickie's little dignity.
That's enough.
Yes, you gave up dignity the day you popped the cork on that bottle. Pop! What a shot! A shot heard round the world. Dickie's popped his little cork. Pop! 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 Pop!
Snap! Pop. Snap! Snap, you little viper!
Stop it!
You missed. Come on. It's the game of chicken.
I don't like our games. I hate our games.
Don't be sad.
I'm not sad. Bloody petticoats. It's like getting dressed 5 times over again. Not like you. These pantyhose.
Madam, may I remind thee that I am thy husband and thy lord, thy life, and thy crumpet,
thy pain in the ass.
Oh, yes, indeed. Come! Come! Ah. Elizabeth, it's for you. I get a cocktail coming on. Elizabeth, what is it?
Monty. Monty's dead.
Let him go. He was a broken heart. Nobody could have saved him.
we were too busy being us. I forgot Monty.
You fell in love. You got married. He never expected anything from you. You got him a job. Reflections in a golden eye.
He was the only one I could tell everything to. Even things that were very private.
He loved you.
Bessie May. He loved Bessie May. God, I had many proposals, but he was the only man that I should have asked to marry me.
Sad affair. Was it a drug overdose?
A life overdose.
Elizabeth Taylor is not here tonight. She's in the south of France. Accepting her Oscar will be her dear friend, Miss Anne Bancroft.
They just gave you an Oscar, and you're complaining.
I'm not complaining for me. I'm complaining for you.
I'm a chronic complainer. I don't need help.
Damn, this is your fifth nomination, Richard. You deserve the Oscar, not me.
We've named the yacht after our three girls. Kate, Liza, and Maria. Kalisma.
I'm so happy.
It's quaintly comforting that a mere yacht can make you happy, my love.
Thank you. Where are you going? People are coming. We're going to celebrate.
Yes, I hadn't forgotten. I'm taking the launch to pick up some of my mates.
You mean those other drunks?
No. I mean the other actors, the thespians, Elizabeth, who have come from afar to celebrate your crowning achievement.
I was just asking.
No, you weren't. You were concerned about whether I was going to fall off the wagon which I've been clinging to so desperately for the last 13 days. Well, don't worry, love, because you see, I'm one of its last remaining passengers.
Well, I can't tell you all of the whatever specifications. Richard knows them. But bonjour, Jean-Paul.
Bonjour, Elizabeth.
Anyway, all I know is it feels like home.
Jean-Paul, j'ai envie de la faire pipi.
You're late.
Oh, and you're a very pretty girl.
Richard, you started drinking again?
Have I?
Mrs. Taylor, happy birthday, my dear. I have to tell you, 40? You don't even look. Well, how about my being a grandma last year? Would you believe it? I refuse to believe it. Oh, well, then don't. I need all the help I can get.
I can't believe that you would allow Richard to put on this shindig here in Budapest and to fly in all these guests.
Well, Mummy, you know, we have to because he's shooting Bluebeard here. And with eight wives, I don't want him hanging around all those Bluebeard broads without me.
Oh, seriously.
I don't.
Here you are, Mom.
I was painless. Or should we say, legs tied together.
Oh, dear. Who's Richard Boring over there now?
It's the Swiss ambassador and his wife.
You see.
Noah's Ark gently flowed down my inner thigh.
Darling, not one of your old stage stories. Give the old Vic a break, will you?
Oh.
Please excuse us.
I'm terribly sorry. She's terribly rude.
Madam.
I'm sorry, Richard. I have to see this up close.
Oh.
Oh, of course, Your Highness.
The Krupp, isn't it? The Krupp diamond.
Yes. Little present from Richard.
I saw it in the paper. Front page.
Yes, that's the way we like it, love. Diamonds on the front page and bad reviews on the back. Oh, you look a little thirsty, love. Let me fill you up. Hold that.
Thank you. Most vulgar thing I've ever seen.
Would you like to try it on?
Oh.
Well, it doesn't look so vulgar now, does it?
Darling, the scribbler is here from the whatever, that journal, the cinematic magazine. I'll handle it.
Mr. Burton.
Yes, Mr. Durham.
Durham.
Oh, whatever. Nice. Sit down.
I'm extremely grateful.
Sad to say that my beloved is ill today.
I'm sorry. Maybe I should come back.
Oh, nothing serious. We just think it's German measles.
You're joking.
She'll be up in a day. We've prescribed her Italian vodka. Quite remarkable. Tastes like paregoric. Go ahead.
Sir?
Your interview.
Oh, yes.
I hope you haven't come prepared to ask us about the recent flops we've been having.
Richard, I can hear you.
Yes. We've only had four flops in a row, actually, but some of them had merit, small merit.
I'm sure this gentleman would prefer to come back when it isn't raining.
Not so. He's a veritable duck. You don't mind the rain, do you?
Not at all.
When it isn't raining, perhaps you'll have sunnier things to say,
Yes, yes. You're racing.
We're crawling.
I've always been of the opinion that Mother Nature, like one's mother-in-law, should be visited, but sparingly.
It's the drink that wears you out. And the cigarettes.
It's arthritis, actually. Which reminds me, medication time.
Oh, Richard, I worry about you.
Me too. That's why I drink.
You really regret taking a few days here? I mean, look around. The chalet, the mountains. Did you ever believe we'd have a life like this?
Oh, yes. This is precisely the kind of life I thought we'd be having. Apart from our occasional trip to this snow palace, we have a life of hotel rooms and rented houses and, oh, yes, that yacht, that luxuriously appointed floating prison.
I don't like your tone, Richard.
It's a life. Or a half-life, actually. And to make up for the missing half, I drink twice as much.
Oh, stop it, Richard.
Oh, I'll stop. I'll die of drink. And you shall go on blithely in your half-world.
Do you have to say these things? I mean, I know you think them, but must you say them? Constantly? Are you going to hold up?
I'll hold up. Bloody Marys will hold me up. Bob, two large Bloody Marys.
Okay.
I hate to leave you here. New York is dreadful this time of year.
Oh. Right. You go off to the coast. I'll be fine. Fine. It's always dreadful out there anyway. Always open season if you like small game.
We haven't gone off on our separate ways in a long time. We're doing the right thing?
Oh, it's been a long time since we've done the right thing.
Richard.
Doing the right thing. It's like seeming and being. Being and seeming. The Dick and Liz show. We're like Laurel and Hardy.
I've always been fond of Laurel and Hardy.
Oh, yes, well, we're not as cute. Not anymore. Everybody's sick to death of us. Especially me. Especially me. I know. We need new writers.
Premier Airlines flight to Los Angeles.
That's my plane.
Now ready.
Miss Taylor, it will escort you.
Keep it waiting for an hour. Just so they know that it's you.
Goodbye, Daffy.
Bye-bye.
Like this? To the press.
I just can't face him. I am convinced it would be a good and constructive idea if Richard and I were separated for a while. Maybe we loved each other too much. I never believed such a thing was possible. But we have been in each other's pockets constantly, never being apart but for matters of life and death. I believe with all my heart that the separation will ultimately bring us back to where we should be, and that's together. Wish us well during this difficult time. Pray for us.
Evening. I'm your date tonight.
Well, then you must be John Warner.
Yes, ma'am. There's no question who you are.
Oh, call me Elizabeth. I can't even remember a time. Must have been a teenager when I had my last blind date.
Well, we're awfully grateful over at the Bicentennial Committee that you agreed to attend our little ball here in Washington.
Well, consider it my patriotic duty. Tell me about yourself.
Well, there's not much to tell. I'm a Virginian. I got a farm down there. I work in the government. One day I plan to run for senator.
Oh. You have a farm?
Yes, ma'am.
And you have animals?
You betcha.
I love animals. Beautiful.
It's nice of you coming all the way out here with me.
This is my childhood. Really, I feel like I'm back in England.
You like it?
Yes. Have you ever instantly fallen in love with a place?
Tell me about yourself, Elizabeth.
I'm still reeling from my second divorce from Richard. Richard Burton.
Yes, I know who he is.
Oh, you've met him?
No, but I've read about it. Like everyone else in America.
Well, for a change, what you've read in the papers is pretty much true. I've had 5 husbands and 5 divorces.
Well, sounds a little discouraging.
Well, only if you believe in love.
Heard it, folks. I'm John Warner, and I'm looking to be your
her too.
Say to Republican fat cats.
I wish you wouldn't say that.
God, I haven't even met them. I've already said something wrong.
Sound like you're in the enemy party.
Well, I'm your wife. That's my party.
And it is a privilege to introduce the next senator from the Old Dominion State, our new senator, John Warner and Mrs. Warner.
Well, thank you. I would like to introduce the real power behind my campaign.
My country wife, Elizabeth.
Yeah. Thank you all for your wonderful, warm Virginia welcome. I want you all to know how at home I feel here in the Old Dominion. And I haven't felt this way for quite some time.
Sort of get-up might go in California, but here in Virginia, we have something we like to call taste.
Doesn't bother John.
I would like to
the more attention that lady gets, the closer he is to the Senate.
We Virginians have to stick together. Now, I would never minimize the contribution that women have made to this country, but we cannot ask the fairer sex to go into combat. That is not acceptable to most Americans.
John.
And any so-called equal rights amendment that would put a woman in harm's way, that cannot be condoned. Women cradle civilization. And to ask them to face the harshest reality of modern existence, we can't do that.
Oh, boo.
What, Elizabeth?
No, women have been facing the harshest realities of life since the beginning of time. I just don't see how you can...
Well, I think I see
choice,
that we will have a discussion of foreign policy. I'll be on the Hill till late. Stay in Georgetown.
I see you want little milkmaid to stay down on the farm.
Well, you don't want to become a Washington wife. They all turn ugly.
Yeah, and fat.
People are talking, making jokes on TV.
Oh, why the hell don't they run the news? Not my before and after pictures. I didn't marry you to sit on the sidelines.
Why did you marry me?
To be happy. But I'm stuck out here in this chicken coop, in paradise, alone. Almost. How do I look? No response required. I'm never putting on that weight again.
You look wonderful. In fact, if my arthritis permitted, I'd do a pirouette myself.
I see that you've been medicating your back again.
Ah, yes, I have.
Oh.
It hurts me.
You know, it's not the pills. It's a cocktail of pills and booze. That'll kill you.
That'd be ridiculous.
Yes.
Oh, well.
See you on the boards, love.
It's like a great bath of love.
What?
It's applause. Every time it's like being loved all over again.
Sally.
Oh, yes, of course I know Sally.
Hello.
Hello, Sally. So you two have been naughty. I understand you went to Las Vegas.
Yes, for the weekend, and, we got married.
Beg your pardon?
Married.
That's strange. I thought you said married.
Yeah, it's like a great bath of love. And sometimes we all have to lower ourselves into it.
Well, congratulations. Richard?
Elizabeth. Okay, who's taking the pen?
Listen to me. You're in trouble. You are in very serious trouble.
Wait a minute. What happened? Did I faint or something? What happened?
It's pills, honey. And alcohol. You do have a very, very serious
That's
problem.
That's ridiculous. I don't have a problem
Mother,
with alcohol.
Mother, listen to me. You
are
hurting yourself. Mother,
alcohol.
You are hurting yourself. Elizabeth, listen, please. You're hurting your family, too. Do you know that?
Am I hurting you?
Yes. Please.
Real problem. I don't like the name Liz.
Sorry.
And I don't do kitchens.
Ma'am, this is the Betty Ford Center. We do whatever it takes. And above all, we don't drink or use, even if
our ass falls off. Yes, I know. I'm Elizabeth Taylor, and I'm an alcoholic.
Thank you, Elf, for sharing your experiences with us. Elizabeth, can you recall what event or incident it was that caused you to recognize the fact that you had a problem?
I still have a hard time believing I'm actually here. But,
Yes, but I remember waking up in the hospital, surrounded by friends and family, and they said that that I had a problem.
We all have a problem. That's why we're here.
Well, I guess I'd become an alcoholic, and that combined with the painkillers I was taking, I couldn't handle it.
At least you didn't try to hide it. You had the courage to come out in the open.
Well, yes, I just hope to God that that's all behind me now.
That woman doesn't have one single unexpressed thought in her head. No longer mourn for me when I am dead. Then you shall hear the surly, sullen bell give warning to the world that I am fled from this vile world with vilest worms to dwell.
I love you, Richard. And I will never cease loving you. Hey, Rock.
All right, Bessie.
Oh.
Careful who you kiss.
I always kiss gorgeous men.
Not so gorgeous. Not no more.
Oh, baloney.
Not like you. You piss me off. You look as good as you did when we made Giant.
Well, boy, are you some actor? Who wrote your lines, hmm?
Nah. I'm serious. You look great. How's your life?
Oh, you know me, kiddo. I'm a survivor. It's in the genes.
Well, you always did look hot in your jeans.
Hey, partner. What do you say we head on back to Texas?
Hmm? I'd like to go back. Anywhere. About Texas. Chocolate martinis.
Okay, then I'll get you one.
Just one.
No, a whole batch.
Chocolate martinis.
I am tired and I am grieving. I am tired of us having to convince the world out there that AIDS is a universal threat to all mankind. I have held a good friend in my arms as his body began to fail, and I am compelled by grief. The delays in confronting AIDS tragically remind me of the high price to be paid when prejudice prevails. AIDS has taught me how fragile human existence is and that every life is to be cherished.
Are you going to act again, Miss Taylor, or are you just going to pursue this AIDS work?
Well, I don't know if I pursue it or it pursues me, but...
Here's Taylor.
What did you say?
Thank you.
Since Rock Hudson's death, I guess it's made the work a little easier.
Yes, well, you know, I'll tell you what amazes
me. Can I give us a look over here, Miss Taylor?
It's truly amazing. I call good friends of mine and ask them to be a part of this. Lifelong friends. And they duck out on me. They just don't return my calls.
Well, you know, it's AIDS.
People are embarrassed.
Yes, but that's terrible. I mean, it's like alcoholism. It shouldn't be a disease of shame, and it is.
Well, what can you do?
Well, we can all do something. Try to make people aware. I believe that's the first step. That's what I'm trying to do.
Thank you. Over here, Ms. Taylor. Over here. Ms. Taylor.
Thank you, Ms. Taylor.
One more question. One more shot.
No, she's handling the press pretty well. Right. Well, we arrive at 2:30 L.A. time. I'm afraid she's going to have to see the doctor, though. Yeah, I'm afraid so.
I don't know what got me back here. I don't know. I turned to booze, food.
Yeah.
Pills, again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's always the pills.
For me, too.
Yes, but these were prescription.
Yeah. You know,
they were prescribed to me for my back. Demerol, Percodan, Valium.
All in one day?
Hey, give me the name of that doctor.
Oh, honey, you're just like me. I beg your pardon. Give me pills, booze, food, men. Nothing's ever enough. Yes, but you don't equate alcohol and pills with men. Yes, it's a love addiction. Look at me, I've been married 4 times, and I never found anything, not in this lifetime, to fill up that great big emptiness inside. My God, I've never thought of love as an addiction. So your name's Larry?
Yeah, Larry Fortinsky.
And what do you do, Larry?
I move Earth.
I'll bet.
I operate Earth moving equipment.
Oh, I'm impressed.
Do you, want to walk?
Okay. I'm a bit slow at the start. Maybe I should get a job moving Earth. God knows I need something. My career, almost dead.
But you're Elizabeth Taylor.
Being Elizabeth Taylor used to be good and sufficient reason for waking up every morning. Now it just seems so nothing.
Oh, come on, don't talk like that. You're still full of fire. You have your age charity. And how many people that matter care about people like you do? Well, even that's bigger than being Elizabeth Taylor, huh? No offense.
It's okay, kid. I can take it. Someone suggested I start a new career. In perfume.
There you go. What would you call it?
What do I know best?
What?
Passion.
John, just walk in.
This is it.
Wow. You want some? Yeah. That is a double decker. Pickles, onions, relish, mustard, mayonnaise with fries. You got enough fries?
Oh, yes. But I haven't been to a place like this in years.
Right, well, it's not exactly the typical Bel Air Palace, but... Ready to leap?
Yes, let's leap. What?
I have never met anyone like you before. It's scary. It's wonderful.
Well, it could be dangerous. What if we fall in love?
I think I already have.
How's my little girl?
Happy. And about to be 60.
Well, that's not so bad. What's important is that those 60 years have been good ones. You've had a wonderful life.
And I've known great love.
And you've given great love.
Hey, oh, hello.
Picture time.
Uh-oh.
Here we go. Come on, everybody.
Oh, Mike. Hello.
All right, line up. Let's get us all together here. Good.
Oh, no, no, no. Everybody in the picture. Will you take this, please?
Thank you.
Okay, do it. Take it down, Mel. You come in. Oh, wait, what about my makeup?
Oh. Just kidding.
There's only one Elizabeth Taylor.
Thank God for that.